EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Arizona Cardinals and the Seattle Seahawks. Now this will make it into the end zone. Spins by. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
At their own 31-yard line.
Scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he'll hope that this is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by Buda Baker.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 31-yard line.
On second down now. It's Hunt, and he'll get this up to about the 40. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Nine brings up third and one.
Stop, stop, stop. They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. The gain of four that time as the drive continues. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards and a Seattle first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
On first down, Carroll. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special ones in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a second time.
Some motion before the snap, and this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. The full start backs him up five, first and 15. Up getting four down to the 36.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because
down the numbers, there he goes, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Kareem Hunt with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories. And you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do. And when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won two games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there. That nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
24-yard line.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 24. Here's the first carry for Kenyon Drake. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. That toss play right, we know it's one of the successful plays they have in their arsenal, and they showed you why there.
And remember, in order for it to be successful, because it's a little bit of a slower developing play, those blocks at the line of scrimmage have to be kept, have to be held, so that the runner can get to the corner and turn it upfield.
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. An excellent gain, 35 yards.
Cardinals.
To throw, it's Murray. That is caught at the 7. And he'll be out of bounds. That's good for 28 yards.
Pardon me to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, a nice big play there.
Three plays, three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, oh.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona.
Touchdown.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
The extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27.
27-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That gain on third down, good for 28.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the Cardinals' 43-yard line.
2nd and 11. Now it's 3rd and 5. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
They'll look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it, and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
Now let's see how the offense still out there. They elect to go on 4th and 11. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You going to let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run toss to the right with Drake. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set them back for second down. Now the pass, and it's into the arms of Hopkins. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and the Seahawks have recovered.
Murray's pass complete. A fumble on the play. Recovered by the defense.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
And just one tick to go, so this will obviously be the final play of this first quarter. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And he will be brought down, but he's got the interception on the final play of this first quarter. 7-7, our score after one.
The score tied 7-7.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
This one complete to Christian Kirk. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
He's a gain of 6. And it's
Murray to give. This is Trey. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
I like the look that they just showed there. When you come out in a passing formation, spread things out a little bit, makes it really hard to cover the middle of the field, doesn't it? Because you've got to go out to the perimeter and cover those guys.
Yep, exactly. Got some good blocking, too. Helped him pick up the first. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 25 yards that time.
Arizona.
Now is Murray. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. On first and goal, Drake. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Kenyon Drake. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Cardinals have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Cardinals 14, Seahawks 7.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And able to break this out all the way to the 38-yard line. Great return.
At their own 38-yard line.
Let's go now. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. That 7-0 lead of theirs is short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by seven.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a 3rd down.
On 3rd down, here's Hunt. And he gets this one across midfield for the 1st down of the 46. The drive stays alive, a 3rd down gain of 8.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up 3rd downs in the top 5 in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, it started in the offseason. 3rd down's important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
And a really good show of force there as he gets through for 4 tough yards.
4 yards on the
at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Here's Hunt, and he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
And that run was memorable for only one reason. There was absolutely no place to run with the football. No gaps, no creases, no gain.
The Seahawks on 3rd down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the 1st before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
1st and 10 at the 35-yard line.
They'll run on 1st down. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
A good run got 7 on 1st. Here's 2nd and 3. Now a give right side. Harrell, and he's going to be stopped up just short of the 1st down at the Cardinals 22. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Right back to him on 1st down, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Brings up second.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 2nd quarter. 14-7. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
A lot of times it's that 1st read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. From the shotgun. He'll look to throw. Now they're staring at a fourth down as Arizona's defense does its job. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down. And his kick is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So a dozen plays on that drive, CD, but in the end, it yields just the 3 points.
Well, they were able to keep the defense on the field for a long time, but let's be honest about it. That was about as unsatisfying a drive as you're going to get. 12 plays and you only get 3 points out of it. Not quite the ending they were looking for.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Murray again, second and 10. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Third and 2, and here's Murray. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. A Cardinal first down, Murray to Hopkins.
First down, Cardinals.
Now Murray again. And looking for Kirk, but this pass is intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback. He expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. They'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you can see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. Ross Blacklock on the tackle.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here. Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off as the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. He'll drop to throw, and it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll try the left side. Harrell. And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
Third and 10.
So we have reached halftime with the visiting Cardinals out in front. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. The Cards with the lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. And this, a very, very short kick. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
Over first and 10 at their own 33-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. On first and 10, here's Murray. The hookup on the right side to Hopkins. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
It's a game.
23 yards, the final tally. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Third throwing is Murray on third down. He's got a man. It's Williams. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. But make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way, oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover it. That type of indecision can open up even more big plays.
And he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Kenyon Drake with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Cardinals push further out in front. Sly for the PAT. For the point after. It's good, and it's 21-10.
Makes the score Cardinals 21, Seahawks 10.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They'll look to make some inroads here, trailing 21-10 as they come up on a first and 10. And he got blown up on that play, back at the 20. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. Second and 15. And that is incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Out of the gun now on third down. And that is incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And this will be down just on the other side of midfield.
Take over first and 10 at their own 46-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he is down deep into Seattle territory. So a little extra on top of the big play there.
It's tough for guys rushing the passer, but you have to know when the ball is gone. And if you listen, officials will tell you ball's gone. He didn't pull up.
Murray now on first down. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Back to the air on second down. It's Murray. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. 5 yards.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
Murray now, third and goal. eluding the pressure right. And this is going to be incomplete.
Keeper thrown away and incomplete. It's now fourth and goal.
The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal. They're going for it. Hits Murray. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. It's the former Michigan man, Chase Winovich, who gets in there to bring him down. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
They've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
They'll run again with Hunt. Accelerating and off he goes. The 20. And he gets this down deep inside of Arizona's 15-yard line. A big run by Kareem Hunt. 62 yards.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes a defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
Second and 11. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. They'll try to run with Hunt. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the 1.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. On second down, Harrell. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. A great effort there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again. The Seahawks offense staying put out on the field. They're going to go for 2. Try and throw for it. Blitz coming and down he goes.
Well, they tried to get 2 and ended up getting none because the quarterback had nowhere to go with the ball and ends up getting sacked.
Nowhere to go at all. Great job, though, defensively. They were ready. Here's Carter now on the return. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
28-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Now a man open.
up and down the middle of the field.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
A gain of 11.
11 yards there. First down.
Arizona.
On the toss play, this is Drake. The first down and more for Drake. And brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down.
First down, Cardinals.
Now on first down, Drake again. 20! And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown.
Arizona.
Kenyon Drake, 49 yards. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead.
Makes the score Cardinals 28, Seahawks 16.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. On first down, Harrell. He gets it forward for four, maybe five, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Yard line, and that'll be marked down as their first sack of the game.
Well, they had six last week, and this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back, and they did a great job in the first half. But now they've gotten their first sack here in the second half. Look out, they'll try to increase the pressure.
They'll run with Hunt on second down. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there. They've got a ways to go now on third down. Looking to throw. And he's going to go down. He backed up into the end zone, and this is going to wind up a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you feel like you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Yeah, still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Running, it's Drake. Fights through, and now a crease.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Murray going to throw. This one caught by Isabella. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 yards on the play, first down.
Another nice pick up through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball this.
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by J.C. Jackson, and a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. That is a play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Good starting field position here for the Seahawks as they come up 1st and 10 at their 36-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. They'll find Moreau here. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. 36-yard line. Pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range, and guess what?
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking
it off.
And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. The interception was a good starting point, but still a huge hill to climb with his 3-score deficit and time fading. A pass there over the middle to start things out. A gain of 6 there on first. That's just his 2nd catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. They've done a great job of doing that.
And he whips that one incomplete there.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Jerry Tillery. And the Cardinals will now take over with excellent field position. On 1st down, Drake. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up 2nd and a yard.
They stay on the ground with Drake. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Taken down at the.
Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line.
1st down, Arizona.
To throw, it's Murray. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Another try after the 1st down sack. Murray. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
It has been a good game for them. They haven't been pressured very much today. But on back-to-back sacks, maybe the defense is starting to figure something out.
Murray with a 3rd and long. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And incomplete, almost intercepted. Had a great shot of picking that off in the end zone. And now 4th down.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on 4th. Throwing now is Murray. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. I think it's safe to say this is a game he's not going to forget anytime soon, Charles. 3 interceptions.
It's rare that we see 3 interceptions by one team, let alone by an individual. And I think that after the 2nd one, he's probably telling his teammates, any ball that's in the air, it's going to be mine. And that turned out to be true.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 36 yards on the play. So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion. You figure defensively, you're in the 4th quarter here, you've held the team under 100 yards passing. You've done your job.
Especially in today's NFL, which is truly a pass-first league.
And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line, Yannick Ngakoue, his 2nd sack of the night. The Seahawks on 3rd down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This will be 3rd and 19. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's 4th down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a 4th down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a 1st down. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on 4th.
2-yard line.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on 1st down. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. A great play there. His
second TD of the game and 18th of the year. And the Seahawks are able to cut into that deficit. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead will be cut down to 14.
Seahawks 23. Michael Dixon to kick off for Seattle.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Takes it at the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but... And intercepted! Maybe the turning point they need. Trey Flowers picks it. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown!
Touchdown!
Well, don't change that channel just yet. This one may have gotten a bit more interesting.
Put down the remote, put down the clicker. This one looked like it was over. It looked like they were ready to seal the deal. But in doing so, by pitching it around a little bit, it cost them. We could have a great finish.
Michael Dixon to kick off.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Short, short kick. One of the up middle take it down. Oh, a good-looking return set up here.
Take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Murray trying again after the pick six. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Wow, a personal foul at this stage in the fourth. Hard to believe.
Really hard to believe. And now that glow of hope that you had begins to flicker out, doesn't it?
Yep.
Check 23 years.
Murray to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Cardinals will extend their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. They're going to take this up close to the 40, so really good starting field position.
8-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Good drive last time, really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this, and I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Very short kick. This will be a hit and a loose football. Oh, good return up past the 30.
When you kick off and you go downfield and get the ball back, that's what I call a great opportunity.
In a one-score game, I always circle, and you know this, but in my play-by-play sheet, I circle big plays. It could be turning points. This could be a turning point.
Did you put a second circle around this one?
I put a star.
Check 13.
back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got three timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. They'll run on first down. Hunt. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Top for the end zone, and that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Pause in the action because the booth, they see something that they want to take another peek at to find out if this was a touchdown or not.
That's the reason we ball for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
So the ref makes a call, no touchdown there, wipe it off the board. So down 6, and they know they need this one on fourth down. He's back to throw, going for it all, and this is caught, touchdown, and now they're an extra point away from winning this thing in the final seconds.
Well, that's the one they had to have, put them in a position where they're tied up, but I got to get out of the way. We still got an extra point that's pretty crucial.
That's right, just one more element to complete the victory. A very important extra point there, up and good, and that might be enough to win the football game as they now take the lead in the final seconds. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one, whether you're able to get into field goal range, or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
Let's see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. To throw is Murray. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson.
tonight's final score.
Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, three, four, five plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it, and they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So for the Seahawks, the win will move them to 7-2 now on the year. And they'll get another home date next week as the 49ers will come to town. Meanwhile, for Arizona, it's their first stumble of the season as they'll dip to 8-1 on the year. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Washington. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.